Well, I think the person who stands out for me is Winston Churchill. I don't think democracy in this country would have survived but for him in 1940, when there were a lot of people in this country who felt that Hitler's might could not be resisted, it would have been better to sue for peace and so on. And he was the symbol of defiance. And I mean, to my mind, we wouldn't be here now if it hadn't been for his providing the willpower that we were going to resist what was going on across Europe at that time. And it was the force of his personality, his determination, which I think helped democracy to survive. Well, I think the first general election which impacted upon me was the 1951 election. I had a vague recollection of the excitement of the 1950 election, which went very close, and the prospect of a change of government. I felt that I was a natural conservative, and some excitement about the prospect of Winston Churchill, who was something of a hero of mine, coming back into power. There had been some austere years following the war, which Labour had had to get through, and had become very unpopular. And so the slogan of setting the people free, which the Conservatives used, to me was quite exciting. The first time that I was conscious in my lifetime of a change of government and a whole set of new ministers coming in and so on. So 51 for me was the one that really embedded my interest in the political system, and thereafter, with all elections, I was totally fascinated and remain fascinated by the process of the count by constituencies and so on.